Many times when you create a form in Excel, you need to copy it down a column. In this worksheet called Employees, we're about to put in a formula in column L. I'm going to scroll to the right a bit and click on cell L1 for the moment. And in that lower right-hand corner, there's a zoom slider bar. I'm going to click the plus a few times to zoom in. We're going to be writing a formula here, and we need to copy it down the column. We could write the formula in a number of different ways. One way is certainly equal K2 times, and everybody's going to be getting a 3.73% increase, so we'll click on cell M2. Since we will be copying this down the column, that needs to be an absolute address, so press the function key F4, and then plus K2. And there's our answer for that entry. If I only needed to copy this 5 or 10 cells downward, I'd simply drag the lower right-hand corner, like that. And that's fine. But in this list, which is over 700 rows, dragging it down to the bottom, if you pardon the pun, is a real drag. We don't want to do that. Let me undo this last action. Excel senses, you might say, that this data is next to a large list. So we can double-click the lower right-hand corner. What happens? The formula gets copied downward. But you don't necessarily know at first, if you're not too familiar with this feature, did the formula get copied all the way down to the column? The follow-up to this is not so well known, but simply press Control Period. That takes us down to the bottom. Now, if you weren't sure that's the bottom, you can scroll a little bit more. It certainly is. Press Control Period again. Control Period simply moves the active cell around the corners of a highlighted range. And when we do copy formulas this way, Excel not only copies the formula, but it also keeps the cells highlighted. And this works surprisingly over in column R. Some of you may be familiar with the term custom list. Built into Excel are four different custom lists, one for full spellings of the months, another for the monthly abbreviations, and also correspondingly for days of the week as well. So if I type January right here, and I want the other months to be below this, there are 12 sales entries there, I'll double click that lower right-hand corner. It's called the fill handle. We see what's happened here. And that's certainly handy at times too. In other situations, we don't really need this shortcut. In the example over here to the right, in columns A, B, and AC, both of these are tabulating data from columns V through AA, so the formula here is doing this. I need to copy this downward, but not into row 5. Same thing over here. We can highlight both of these, but here, instead of a double click, we'll simply drag. But as we saw in the previous examples, many, many times you need to copy a formula down a column. And it's much more likely to be used with a formula the way we saw in column L, but we can also use it with these special built-in custom lists as well. It's a real time saver. And unfortunately, as powerful as that ability to copy a formula down a column is, there is no corresponding shortcut for quickly copying formulas across a row, which admittedly is needed not nearly as often.